so lonely, broken angel. I'm so lonely.
Mehmet Simsek, welcome to Hard Talk.
Thank you.
I think we have to begin with Turkey's military operation over its border in northern Syria. It is a dramatic intervention in the affairs of Syria. You said when it began weeks ago that it would be very brief. It no longer looks as though it is going to be brief.
Well, first of all, we had no choice but to do this operation. It's all about securing our border, you know, safety and security of our people. Over the course of 2017, we had experienced about 700 skirmishes or attacks originating from and around Afrin area. So clearly, Turkey's intervention is not an intervention aimed at either, you know, Syrian territorial integrity or against any ethnic group. We have no quarrel with either Kurds. We want a unified and, you know, stable and peaceful Syria.
But if so, I may, there's a disingenuousness about Turkey's position. I mean, you talked about it being brief. President Erdogan indicated it would be a sort of in-and-out operation. But in recent days, we've heard a colleague of yours, another Deputy Prime Minister, Bekir Bozdag, saying that if the YPG, that is what you call the PYD, the group that you call a terror group, but a group which the Americans have worked with for some time in northern Syria, your colleague said if the YPG doesn't leave Syria's Manbij, Turkey will move there too and towards the eastern areas of the Euphrates River, and their operation will last as long as is necessary. It's a long-running fight. Very different words from yours.
Okay, we're paying a maximum attention to make sure that, you know, the operation is surgical and we don't have civilian collateral damage. So that's why it's moving very slowly. Now, as far as Manbij area is concerned, Manbij, prior to recent conflict, it was 95% populated by Arabs. Most of those, that Arab population is now refugee in Turkey. So essentially PYD-YPG, which is a subsidiary of PKK.
Well, so you say.
Well, it is.
The Americans clearly,
U.S. administration has admitted that.
Well, do not accept your characterization of the YPG as a terror organization. In fact, they have trained them, they have offered them support, and we know that the Americans who have a base close to Manbij are looking at incorporating elements of the YPG into a so-called border force.
United States have initially denied that they were working with a subsidiary or a direct offshoot of PKK, which is on their terror list. They camouflaged it as SDF, Syrian Democratic Forces. But reality is it is dominated by PKK leadership, PKK militants. You can watch a Senate hearing where the ex-US defense minister admits that PYD-YPG is largely related to PKK. Now you could, but let's get back. Now Manbij essentially was subject to ethnic cleansing. U.S. administration had promised on numerous occasions that they would pull back to east of Euphrates so that the refugees could come back. But they never delivered on their commitment.
But from what you're saying, the bottom line is this is going to be a very long-running operation. If you want to change the demographics of Manbij, as you've indicated to me, well, this could go on for months. Syrian territory could be occupied by Turkish forces for a very long time. And you also, as I've just mentioned, you could come up against American military personnel if you insist on going into Manbij.
Well, first of all, we have no interest in controlling a single inch of Syrian territory. We have no interest. I want to make that clear. We're not there on a permanent basis. We're there because our national security you know, concerns have forced us to go there. Secondly, yes, we do want to see stabilization in the region so that 3.5 million Syrians, which makes Turkey the world's largest refugee hosting country, to go back and resettle in their own home and then territory. We're not talking about changing demographics.
This operation is much more about your fight with the Kurds than it is about the long-term future of Syria or the nation state.
We have no quarrel with Kurds. Turkey was the first country to help Iraqi Kurds combat Daesh. You can ask Barzani, you know, the leadership of the country. So we have no quarrel with Kurds. In fact, 300, can I just finish this sentence, please? 370,000 Kurds who moved to Turkey from Kobani 3-4 years ago, they are still in Turkey because they are afraid of oppressive regime led by PYD/YPG.
Donald Trump and President Erdogan had a phone call toward the end of January. After it, the White House released a statement saying that President Trump had urged Erdogan to de-escalate, to limit military actions, and avoid civilian casualties. It is quite clear the U.S. is now deeply unhappy with what you're doing in northern Syria.
Well, we are very, very disappointed with the way U.S. is acting in Syria. Imagine a NATO ally that is supposed to be combating, you know, terror, global terror, and Turkey has been there for the U.S., has been a dependable, reliable partner. Imagine, you know, your partner, your ally, moving 10,000 kilometers away, coming to a country where you have 911 kilometers of border, that is Turkey-Syria, and under the pretext of combating another terror group, arm and train another terror group to fight another terror group. Now, clearly, that beats...
Hang on, are you accusing the Americans of essentially arming and supporting a terrorist army?
Well, we know...
Well, just be clear with me. Is that what you're saying?
We know, and the United States knows, that PYD/YPG is a direct offshoot, a subsidiary of PKK.
So that is what you're saying. Let's be blunt about this. Yes. Okay, well, it's an astounding notion that Turkey is accusing the most important fellow member of NATO of running, supporting, financing a terror army. But nonetheless, it leads to this scenario that in the next few weeks, your forces could be going to war with U.S. forces. We know there are 2,000 U.S. special forces around Manbij. There is now a very real risk, maybe inadvertent, of military clashes, confrontation between Turkey and the United States.
We don't want that. Exactly the opposite. We want, with our allies and friends, to combat extremism and terror wherever it is, to stabilize Syria, to help rebuild Syria, to make Syria, which is in our national interest, to make Syria more peaceful, stable, and prosperous. Because you only realize how significant to have a functioning state as your neighbor. I'm so lonely, broken.